Hey guys, Marshall here from Limited Resources and doing a little draft with you here on Channel Fireball, Modern Masters 2015. Got a nice pack here. So there's an Iona Shield of Emeria, which is basically not castable. There's no reanimation spells in this format. You know, you could take it for some tickets or whatever, but I don't think it's worth a ton. And I think I'd rather just take a good card here. And there's plenty to choose from. Sigil Blessing is fantastic. Nameless Inversion, sort of the default pick out of a pack like this. I love me a Rampant Growth in this format, a Lore Scale Quaddle. I love a Cathodian, though I wouldn't take it first here. I kind of think it's between like Sigil Blessing and Nameless Inversion, and I guess I'll just take the Inversion. It's the more solid card. And I've got a second copy of it here, and I'm just going to pick that up. There's some other good cards. Hikari's fine, another Lore Scale Quaddle, a Pillory, but if it was good enough to first pick, it's probably good enough to second pick, so here we are. Wow, this is a pack, too. Two cards, Burst Lightning and Kozilek's Predator. Raise the Alarm, yeah, you know, I note that as well. So Burst Lightning's a better card than Kozilek's Predator, but having two, you know, black and red is not really where you want to start out, though. I can also branch out from there, no problem. Yeah, I'll take the Burst Lightning here. In a weird way, it actually keeps our options open. All right. I guess all we do is take removal, and we'll figure... Holy crap! Why am I getting a fifth pick Moldrifter? There's another Raise the Alarm also. Wow. All right. Well, I'm taking the Moldrifter. Good God. Welcome to the team Moldrifter. Put on a jersey. All right. Here's another Sigil Blessing. I'm tempted to take that here. There's not really a whole lot else going on in the pack. There's a Narcolepsy, which is pretty good, too. I'll take the Sigil Blessing. If I can move into some tokeny thing, then I wouldn't mind doing it. All right, Dread Drone or Hikari. Feels like white's open. I'm going to take the white card here. Hikari's pretty good. All right, so not much out of this pack. I'm going to take the Sphere of the Suns just as a backup plan. We do have a lot of colors going right now. I don't intend to play all of them. I'm hoping that we kind of settle in a little bit here. But I'm just content to take kind of the best card for the first part of the pack here. And I think that the right archetype will reveal itself to us. You know, if we see these that other Sigil Blessing we open comes back, and especially if one or two of those raise the alarms, then we'll know that is an opportunity for us to move in that direction. In which case, you know, we could splash for something, a Moldrifter, a couple of Nameless Inversions, or a Burst Lightning, plus maybe another removal spell. Also, we could end up just being multicolored good stuff. As you can see, all of our stuff is just good. The Sigil Blessing doesn't go in that deck very well, but it can still do some stuff. Okay, one of the Lore Scale Quaddles came back, which is a little interesting to me. It signals that maybe the other one will... which is a possibility. I think I'm just going to take Rampant Growth, which gives us the possible option of going for just infinite different colors. Which I'm fine with. I mean, I've done it a bunch in this format. Lately, I've tended to slot in a little bit more towards, you know, one of the pre-done archetypes, but... It kind of feels like this is one of those drafts where things are just opened up, and, I mean, I'm still just a little bit offended that we got Moldrifter that late. And then double Nameless Inversion, Arrest, Burst Lightning. That's nice. I mean, that's a pretty sweet removal package right there. Just, like, even if we didn't get any more, that would be pretty decent. I mean, I've certainly had decks in this format that had less removal than that total. All right, I'll take this Sylvan Bounty here. Yeah, just looking to keep the options open, I suppose. The second pack could put us into a more firm path here, but I feel like we might just end up being five colors anyway, which, like I said before, I'm totally cool with. In fact, I enjoy. Sunspear Shikari, we're probably not doing the whole equipment thing. I guess I could play this thing. This card always overperforms, and I do have two Nameless Inversion to get back, so that could be a thing. Okay. Well, there's some cards here. There's a Nest Invader, a Scatter the Seeds, another Sphere, which I really don't want to have to run. Splinter Twin for value, which I could just take. I mean, there's nothing amazing in this pack anyway. Take a Golgari Rot Farm, just try to get these Nameless Inversions going or whatever. I think I just want to take Nest Invader. I think it's just the easiest to cast highest value spell. It also just fills out our early game. We have no creatures in the early game, so this is, it's good to have that. Shadow Mage Infiltrator is okay, but I find it often has a hard time getting through. There's plenty of artifacts and artifact creatures, I mean, laying around that end up blocking it. I think I've hit with it a grand total of once ever in the format. I was happy about it, though. Azorius Chancery is a card I could definitely consider taking here. I think I'm going to take it. It's not in love with anything else here anyway. I think it's between these two, and yeah, I'm going to take the Chancery. Wow, this pack has just been a lot worse. I'm going to take this Narcolepsy, but Surkar Spellblade, oof. Still haven't figured out why that guy's in the set. All right, I guess I'm taking another Chancery. This has been insane. The first pack was just stacked up. We got super late Muldrifters. Now we're taking lands instead of actual spells. All right, here's some business. An Etched Oracle or an Agony Warp. I think in a vacuum, I usually end up taking the Agony Warp, but I'm going to take the Etched Oracle here because we've already got so much removal, and Etched Oracle in a 4-5 color deck can be absolutely fantastic. Just such a great card. Can really just be a game winner. I played one a couple days ago, and I think I made a mistake with it. I was a little bit bummed, but I was under some amount of pressure, and I played it out there for four, but it was on turn four, and I got kind of lucky. I had played something to fix my mana, and then had drawn the fourth color of mana, and I couldn't wait, so I slammed it. And I got Otherworldly Journeyed. I was playing against blue-white, and I thought, well, this is pretty safe here. Like, I could get Oblivion Ringed or whatever, but I'm just going to do it. And then, I got Otherworldly Journey, which shrunk it down to a 1-1. If I would have waited one turn, I could have, cashed it in first. Necroskitter's pretty good, but I don't think I can really do much with it, so I'm going to take another Narcolepsy. We're just all removal all the time, it seems. Sure. I don't think we might not end up playing that, but I like Restless Apparition a lot. I don't like cards that are hard to cast in my multicolored decks, though, which is why I was saying I probably won't play the Vampire. But, if we end up being heavy black-white, it does make this a bit more palatable. And it's not like it has to come down on three, but this whole pack has just been a big disappointment. Can't get too picky because the first pack was so insane, but yeah, this one's been bad. So, right now we've got a Rampant Growth and a Sphere. Well, and an Expedition Map. I really try not to play that guy, but you can. You really can. You do what you got to do. just you got to make sure you're searching up a land that's just not a basic. I mean, you don't have to, but ugh. But getting an Azorius Chancery is fine. So we could use some finishers. You know, two finishers would be good. Lightning Bolt, Cathodian, Midnight Banshee. How far over towards black can we really push here? It feels like not that hard. Like, because we do have double Nameless Inversion, Restless Apparition, Outcast. I just don't think we're going to be able to get that thing down. And if that's the case, I think I'd rather just play a Bolt here. Wow. Just literal infinite removal, just any removal spell possible. We just need like a crusher or something up here to, you know, kind of finish things off. I mean, look, with this much removal, a Hikari and an Etched Oracle can get the job done. A lower scale Coil can get the job done. It's not like we need. It's just, you know, a little bit more fixing and a little bit more on the top end. I think this deck would be all ready to roll. It's a lot of removal we got. I don't think I've ever had this much in this format. God. Even more removal. Yeah, let no creature stand alive. I'll say that. I guess I could take the Swan since nobody else can possibly have any removal since we've taken it all. No, I'm going to take one of these two. Soul Eater, I could make an argument for here because it scales up and some of our removal doesn't kill bigger things. You know, we've got an Arrest and a Dismember, but like, you know, the Burst Lightnings and Namelesses don't kill 5/5s and 6/6s or whatever. So I guess I'll take that. Even though I think Burst Lightning's a better card in a vacuum. Well, this is awkward. I'd love to take Indomitable Archangel, but I think I have to take this Bauble. By the way, more removal. I mean, we've only got the Rampant Growth in the Sphere. We've got an Expedition map, but that's pretty mediocre. Sucks because there's a Crusher and an Archangel, which would both be good, but I want to be able to cast my spells. What in the world is happening here? Dimir Guildmage could be interesting. Tribal Flames would be fine too. I'm actually going to take Dimir Guildmage. Not a card I've ever really been super impressed by in this format, but I think that's actually worth it. Fiery Fall. We're really only playing these two red spells. It's going to be pretty tough to cycle it. It's good on the other end. I mean, that part's fine. Don't really see us casting any of these other ones, though. So I guess I'll take it, but not super excited about it. Spider. There's our win condition. Now we're getting there. All right, I'll take the Sylvan Bounty. Break up the Fall. Now I'm just drafting random creatures because they say creature on them. No, I've officially never had this much removal. Not in this format. Burst Bolt, double Narcolepsy, triple Nameless Inversion? That's before we get to 3 mana? What? Then we get Dismember, Arrest, Blinding Soul Eater on top of all that. Obviously our best card is this one. What else is new? Guess that could be a thing. Card is not very good. Kind of like our card draw situation already, too, with the Etched Oracle and the Drifter. We should be able to stay alive long enough, theoretically, here. I don't know. Maybe I do actually play these because, oops, what did I just put in? Sign and Blood, you're out. Could run a Scuttling Death. I also picked up a Moonlit Strider. Both of those get back Nameless Inversion, which we now have three of. So I am actually going to consider that. Though, I just kind of like them because they're creatures, too. We've got 13 creatures as this sits. That's probably enough, but we're at 30. We're going to need to cut down. We're at 28, I should say. We're going to need to cut down significantly here. That's nice. So that seems pretty ambitious, and this Restless Apparition does too, which means that Moonlit Strider and Scuttling Death are probably worth considering here. So we are definitely all of the colors. Our smallest touch here is red, and then otherwise we're fairly evened out in the colors that we need. Strider's pretty mediocre. So is Graft Mage, though I'm starting to get a little worried about number of creatures. If I cut that, I could probably, I wonder if I can sub it in for like an Outcast and like a Sickle Ripper and maybe a Restless Apparition. If we can push this deck hard enough over into black, that could work, because that reduces our blue splash too. Well, it's four cards, but it's just one symbol per. We know we're going to be base black because we want to be able to hit these three Nameless Inversions early to help us stay alive to the later part of the game. But yeah, I think that this is just too much. We're just not going to be able to consistently get in for damage. This is probably pretty close to the build that we want. Maybe just cut one card, one of these removal spells or something. I'm not happy about having to play this sphere, but I do think we need to. Gives us three ramp options plus one mana fixer, which I think is about right. Guess I could kill a Narcolepsy. It's probably our worst removal spell. Could consider running Expedition Map over Sphere of the Suns. Map does get us a more permanent way. And we do have two Azorius Chanceries, which covers one of our splashes and, well, two of our splashes, basically. It doesn't ramp us, but if you look at our curve, our curve actually isn't that high. Maybe I'll try that. I've never actually played map over it before, but I think that could be correct here. Especially with how much removal we have, we probably should have time to get a map for a chancery and kind of generate a little card advantage there too. All right. Oops. All right, well, I'll tell you what. Three mountains is not happening. We're going to play one. And probably two of these and three of these Maybe not, actually. We've got double Azorius Chancery, so I could probably go to 1 and 2. And then that gives us the opportunity to play at least another Forest. Another swamp, and then I guess just another forest here. I like having extra swamps here. All right, there's our deck. We'll see what it does.